Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I would like to extend a special thanks to all the organizers, but on top of all of them, Dr. Isa, for giving me this opportunity to stand in front of all of you and share with you a very basic knowledge which most of the time we underestimate or even forgotten. So when we talk about epigenetic and it's a new field in medicine, we heard a lot about genetics. Previously, we used to think that our gene is our destiny. So what I inherit from my parents, khalas, it's my destiny. But with a new development in science, we reach a level where we can understand that we have the power to control our genes. So when we talk about artificial intelligence, we are simply are able to reprogram our genes. And that is done very successfully on a personal level. You don't need to go to a hospital. You don't need to go to a college for somebody to teach you. You need only to acquire those skills and make it a lifestyle. And we'll start with one of the most effective factors which exactly control our genes. If we can imagine the constructor when he came to build this auditorium, he did all the needed infrastructure, but in the same time, he extended the wire and he fixed all those spotlights. Before leaving this project, there were a switch in the end of the room through which you can control which spotlight should be open in this time and how you would like even the voltage to be in dimming that light up or down. It's exactly how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalala fawqa arshi la ilaha illahu created us. So along with the package of our DNA, which we inherit half from our mother and half from our father, there is a switch through which we can control which gene should open and which gene should close. And that is applied exactly on the development of a human being. For example, now I'm 42 years old and I start to have the white hair only at the age of 27. And that was very strange for me because I thought I will have that after 40s. Then again, that goes back to the switch on and switch off. Why didn't it open that particular gene which is responsible of decreasing those serotonin and decreasing melatonin in my cells, especially melanin cells? Why didn't it happen at age of 14? Why it happened in the age of 28? So that's all controlled by environmental factor. And today when we talk about power of sleep, I am here to share with you some of the skills which made sure by the age of 42, when I examine my telomeres, which is the end of chromosome, I am only 17 years old. Can you imagine? Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. So my heart is 17 years old, and that goes back to the second best gentleman in my life, my dear husband, after my father. So my liver is 16 years old, my kidney 16 years old. That all goes back to the lifestyle, which I only acquired after my visiting to Planet Japan. I studied in Japan for 3 years, the total of 5 years, and during that time, I acquired all those skills, which helped me to improve overall the quality of my genes if I'm not able to change how it looks and the way I inherited from my both parents. As a female, I'm so proud to be born in the United Arab Emirates. And I'm so proud to be born in this era specifically, where women are appreciated, supported, and top of all, she is there on the top of any project. And today I'm so proud to have Dr. Aisha there. I love her so much. She has a very pretty face, and at the same time, very pretty heart. And I touch her in different areas, in the social situation, as well as workplace. That's what makes women, yeah, she is. Allow me, Dr. Isa, this has nothing to do with the power of sleep, but it is a very good reminder for all the gentlemen here and a very good reminder for a woman why she needs to be so proud that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalala fawqa arshi la ilaha illahu created her as a woman, not as a man. Can you see this tiny Y chromosome somewhere in the corner? Can you see him? Okay. These are 46 chromosomes. We get 23 from our mother and 23 from our father. The 44 chromosome exactly will define you as a human being, with a head and arm and forearm and all those organs, while the rest of the two chromosomes will define you as a male or female. So if it happened you had the X chromosome from your mother and Y chromosome from your father, you will end up being a male. And how you develop yourself, that will define you as a gentleman. But as a woman, can you imagine those big X chromosomes? Can you see how ginormous are they? And we keep hearing, Rayal, 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 Rayal. With my full respect to all the Riyayil, you know? Excuse me, science tells that you are that much tiny. And whenever we examine the chromosome, he's always in the corner. Can you imagine? That's the reality. Listen to the funny part of the whole story. Do you know the gene which is responsible of the smartness of a human being to develop, to think, to have all this innovation, where it is located? On X chromosome. Thank you. So that's, we are not underestimating the role of the gentleman in our life. Still, I love my past father, Allah yirhimu yuhsin ilayh. I respect my brother, Ali. I respect all those gentlemen of my life. But again, as a woman, we should know that we are smart by default. So all the development and skills and training, that will add a lot to us. So you need to work on yourself to make sure that you deserve what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defined you as a woman, and make sure you work well with that X chromosome. See how tiny is Y chromosome. and you know, it only gives 50 genetic characteristics to the boy, baby boy, while the X chromosome gives the baby boy 2,500 genetic characteristics. Now we understand when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, he will say, Ummak, thumma ummak, thumma ummak. If you are blessed with a smart boy in the family, so make sure to get a flower to your wife today. And if you are blessed to have a real gentleman as a husband for yourself, make sure you take care of your mother-in-law, because she is the reason behind your happiness. So as a woman, remember that. There is something called telomeres. This is where it defines me and clearly give me the right age, that I am 16 years old, not 42 years old, as a birth certificate shows. So these telomeres, they are affected so much by the environmental factor. And if I get any blood sample or any swab, when I examine the DNA and I see the length of telomeres, I can somehow define to say that this particular organism or a human being, it's having 7 to 10 years to live, not more than that. Because these end of chromosome will exactly define how active is your organ and how long it has for further division for a new cell within. It is exactly like the shoelace. You see the shoelace in the end of the shoelace, subhanAllah, that protects the shoelace from getting damaged. And the same way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala jalla jalali fawqa arshi la ilaha illahu created our chromosome. This cup will maintain the chromosome to stay healthy and help that organ or that human being to work in a healthy way. And as we are aging, the telomeres get shortened and shortened. But the lovely part of the story, that now we can control the length of these telomeres. So it is reversible. Even if I am 42, but still, my organ is only 16 and 17. How I was able to do that? Simply by acquiring all those skills which need and which can maintain the length of my telomeres. There were too many research done, and as a physician, I used to treat my patient when they come to my clinic, when they have diabetes type 2, with all those medication, I'll do the blood test. But I was never taught in the medical college or during my clinical training that I need to ask my patient how long he sleeps at night. And I was not aware at all about the impact of sleep, how it will manage my patient in a better way. And in majority of time, if he will have a very healthy sleep, especially sleep hygiene, for only 6 weeks, his blood sugar will be controlled in such way within the coming 3 months, I can easily stop his medication and control his diet with a good sleep night. And that was again proven with all those clinical studies. The other factor which again helps to elongate your telomeres is meditation. Any type of meditation, yoga, different type of meditation. But as Alhamdulillah Muslim, we have a very lovely type of medication. The 5-time prayer and specifically sujood. When you sit down there and you make sure you have the frontal lobe of your head, of your brain on the ground, and you reach that status where you stabilize all the wave in your brain, alpha and delta, name them. And finally, exercise. When we talk about exercise, many people, they say you need to exercise, it's very good, it's very healthy, but again, it simply elongates your telomeres, which will help your organ to function in a better way. So in one of the experiment, clinical experiment, where we examine 43 candidates, and we examine their telomeres before asking them to have any type of activities for 30 minutes where they can feel their heartbeat, nothing else, not to change anything else in their life. And imagine within 6 months, their telomeres elongated 15 to 20% only with 30 minute exercise. So again, here clearly we are passing a very essential fact to you, that you can reprogram your gene and you can live longer and maintain a better function in performing your daily task. And when we are in a college and university, we know the impact of such exercise and such behavior on your overall function. We hear a lot about the impact of the blue light within our devices on our brain and how it does function. So, as you know, we have a circadian rhythm where all the sleep and get up and all those normal function in our body and the secretion of all those essential hormones are controlled by the sunrise and sunset. Even if we are in a closed room, still the magnetic field around us can detect that, and especially the clock in our brain can detect that very well. And proven that the whole process of this light will affect the secretion of two main essential hormones, melatonin and serotonin. And I would like you to go and read about them and how essential are they in maintaining a healthy brain. Only to simplify the very tough science, really, the science is not easy, but only I'll try to simplify it for you. In an experiment where we give those people who are in something called the sleep studio research. And this is sleep research clinic. We put a cap, electronic cap, on the head of all those candidates who agree to be part of our research. And we try to monitor them while they are sleeping for 6 weeks. And why we are defining 6 weeks? Because the whole circulation and resensitization of those melatonin and hormones take that cycle itself. So by asking them to wear this cup, we can monitor the whole wave and how the connection between the body, the brain, and the rest of the part of the body. You imagine with me, subhanallah wa bihamdi, subhan rabbi al-azim. So as soon those people were wearing those cups, every time they go to bed in this specific studio or this clinic, the observer, they were in the other room and they are not aware at all about any medical history for those candidates who were in the room. What they notice, the first connection after they go in the second stage of sleep, which is the most important part of this stage of the sleep, they notice that that specific area in the brain, which is related, for example, if Miriam's having some problem in her kidney, that area in the brain which is responsible of communication with the kidney, it will be the first area which will be stimulated as soon he will go on the second stage of sleep. And the other candidate who's having, let's say, any knee problem or specific area in his body, that particular area which is defected, it will be the first area which will be stimulated in the brain. So with this in conclusion, I can simplify it for you. So now we are trying to find out what is the tool and the communication language between the brain and the body. So as soon we go on the second stage of sleep, and always it's preferable to go in this stage before midnight. So if you don't like your husband and really he's making your life nightmare, make sure he stays late. Make sure he goes to bed after 2 o'clock. Because if he will go early, he will live long and the whole story will be longer. If you love somebody, make sure they are in bed before 11 o'clock. So what happens, as soon we are at that stage before 11 o'clock, we go on the second stage, subhanallah wa bihamdi subhan rabbi al-azim, brain will start talking to the rest of the organ. Will say, yalla, tell me, what's going on? How can I manage? So kidney will start. I really suffering with Maryam. The whole day she didn't drink a proper amount of water, which is her weight dividing by 30. And then start complaining to the brain. Brain will say, okay, no worries. I'll make sure I re-manage the whole system. So the brain will stimulate and request the thirst center in my brain. Please make sure tomorrow morning with Maryam will wake up. First thing, she will start for water. And make sure that whatever she will eat, all the lining in the intestine will absorb whatever water is there. And he will tell the sweat cell, please don't do complete vasodilatation. Make sure she sweat less. And even if she is sad, make sure there is not too many tears from her eyes. So the brain starts to control our body. And the same is applicable on, let's say, pancreas. Maryam is really eating lots of carbs, she loves sweet, but I'm not able to secrete enough amount of insulin. So the brain will order another part of our brain. Please make sure tomorrow Maryam will get up in the morning, she will start for white egg. If you would like to hear more about epigenetics, we in UAE Genetic Disease Association, we work in a very low profile where we focus mainly to improve the quality of gene of newly born UAE Emiratis by 2020, and we were very successful. We started back in 2005, and when we started, for example, thalassemia and sickle cell was 12, the prevalence was 12%. Now it's dropped to 2.9%, and we work, thank you very much. Again, it's a teamwork. It's not only done by UAE GDA, it's done by 17 nationalities who lives in UAE, and we are all volunteer on board. We were recognized by Harvard Genetic Institute, after which we had 5 Nobel laureates coming in person, visiting our small organization and writing in guest book, UAE GDA is a spot of light in Arab world in genetic research. Thank you. Thank you, Luther.